The most powerful billionaires on our planet want to take their rivalry to the next level. And by next level, we actually mean, that is, outer space. It looks like the battle between billionaires to win the space race and conquer what lies beyond our planet is getting more intense. The term space race is nothing new and has been around since the Cold War, when the Soviet Union and the United States were competing over global supremacy. Fast forward to the 21st century, and we are now seeing the dawn of a new space race. But this time, there are no nation superpowers involved, just three people with some of the deepest pockets in the world. These three individuals and their billionaire space race might change the fate of human civilization. So if that is something you're curious about, well, we got you covered. Make sure to stick till the end of the video to know how we might become a multiplanetary species and maybe even make our first contact with extraterrestrials. Commercial space travel, also known as space tourism, is well on its way to becoming the next big thing, all thanks to the billionaire space race. But what exactly is the billionaire space race? Well, it refers to the rivalry among the most influential billionaires within the aerospace industry with no aerospace background. So, who are these billionaires? Well, we're talking about Jeff Bezos with Blue Origin, Richard Branson with Virgin Galactic, and Elon Musk with SpaceX. First, we have Jeff Bezos' company, Blue Origin, founded back in 2000 with their new Shepard spacecraft named after Alan Shepard, the very first American to make a historic space trip back in 1961. Fast forward 60 years later, in 2021, Blue Origin launched Wally Funk at the age of 82 and Oliver Damon at age 18, the oldest and youngest people to reach space respectively. Blue Origin's goal is to enable a future where millions of people are living and working in space to benefit Earth. Blue Origin believes that in order to preserve our planet, humanity will need to expand and explore along with finding new energy and material resources and move industries that cause a lot of problems on Earth into space. Jeff Bezos envisions a future where some of the industries that cause extreme pollution can be relocated into space to keep the Earth clean. Even though that might be a good idea in theory, it's not entirely possible as of now, at least with the technology that we currently have, because transporting heavy industries into space and bringing the products back to Earth will require massive use of energy and resources, most of which will end up causing more pollution, and these products that are made in space might be extremely expensive. Then we have Sir Richard Branson, the British entrepreneur who began planning for his space flight almost 18 years ago when he founded his company Virgin Galactic in 2004. His dream became a reality on July 11, 2021 when he boarded his Virgin Galactic rocket plane, VSS Unity, and flew 50 miles over the New Mexico desert with the trip lasting for approximately 60 minutes. To give you an idea of how close we are to actually seeing space tourism become a reality, Richard Branson's Virgin Galactic have made plans to begin regular commercial suborbital services at the end of 2022, and they already have 600 reservations at around $450,000 per ticket. So if you are one of those 600 lucky people, you can be sure that you will experience an out-of-this-world ride. The push for space tourism might eventually pave the way to a future where everybody could become an astronaut. Companies like Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin are continuing to work on space tourism flights until they can achieve the kind of volume that airline operators get. This could translate to a future where spacecraft will completely replace airplanes by making suborbital space travel more affordable and a much faster mode of transportation. Finally, we have Elon Musk, the visionary entrepreneur that has revolutionized multiple industries with companies like PayPal, SolarCity, and Tesla's electric cars. Perhaps his biggest project, SpaceX, has had huge success with reusable rockets, giving them the upper hand compared to every other aerospace company out there, which resulted in SpaceX winning NASA's highly significant Artemis project that plans to take humans onto the moon once again after about 50 years, ever since the last Apollo mission. SpaceX is a private company with a pioneering goal to make humanity a multiplanetary species and colonize Mars, even though Jeff Bezos disagrees with Elon's plan. According to Jeff, it's unlikely that humans will survive in another planet because we are not even built to survive the harshest conditions in our own planet. When it comes to the tourism side of things, space tourism is here to stay, at least on a suborbital level, and the goal for companies like Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin is to develop technologies that will support suborbital tourism and make flights more cost-effective and efficient. Space tourism would be the very first step in a real space industry, and anything beyond that would be the domain of SpaceX. SpaceX is way more ambitious than Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin. Elon Musk's vision for SpaceX is to make humanity a multiplanetary species. Colonizing the red planet might be Elon's most bold goal to date, but we don't know how soon it'll become a reality since Musk has the bad habit of missing his deadlines. But then again, Elon Musk has also gained a reputation for accomplishing things no one else has and making the impossible possible. So we should probably give Elon some room to breathe. Like everything else, the billionaire space race has its pros and cons and has also triggered criticism. For instance, a survey reported that more than three-quarters of the people in the United Kingdom think that wealthy individuals like Elon Musk, Richard Branson, and Jeff Bezos should focus on solving the problems that our planet is facing now, like climate change, poverty, and so many other issues before thinking about space travel. Even though that's a valid perspective, we've also learned so many things about our own planet and how to solve our biggest challenges because of the research that has gone into space exploration. The scientific development that is acquired from the space race gives us great insights, not just about our place in the cosmos, but also about our improved quality of life here on Earth. It also brings in economic prosperity, international collaboration, and, most importantly, the scientific knowledge that creates a deeper understanding of ourselves and our planet. The research that went into space exploration is the reason we now have improved solar panels, light-based anti-cancer therapy, lightweight high-temperature alloys used in jet engine turbines, and even the camera that you can find in your smartphone. So you get the idea why space exploration is important, and these billionaires are actually trying to solve the problems of Earth by taking humans to space. The contributions of space exploration to our day-to-day life is a topic for another video. So if you want us to make a video on that, do leave a comment down below, and we will get it done. Last century space race was the competition between two of the world's superpowers, which drove humans to the historical event of landing foot on the moon in 1969. Today's billionaire space race might help us go beyond the moon and even end up colonizing the red planet and become a multiplanetary species. Once the aerospace technology that we have improves, the chances of us contacting the extraterrestrial life is extremely high. And if that does not sound exciting, we don't know what else will. It's too soon to tell if extraterrestrial life might wipe out humanity or if we could coexist peacefully and build a better future for all living beings. In the long term, space travel might be the biggest driver of innovation on our planet because what lies beyond the Earth is still a mystery and mysteries need to be solved. Perhaps not right now, but sometime in the near future.